everybody. Hope you're doing well on this Sunday afternoon. I'm a little fired up today, so if I have to repeat something, please forgive me. I was going to leave this alone. I was really going to leave these Boston bombing thing alone. I had done enough of my own research to come up with my own conclusions, and I wasn't going to do any more videos. But now here we go. We're into more strange events here. Imagine, if you will, let's just imagine that these two boys really were part of a plot to blow up people at the Boston Marathon. But it was a FBI setup sting where they gave these guys the bombs and were going to try to catch them before they did it. Because you actually have to catch somebody doing something, right? You can remember the Bangladesh guy, the national, that was taken into custody after allegedly assembling and attempting to detonate what he believed was a 1,000-pound bomb, and the FBI supplied him with the components. I'm going to leave a couple links to verify that for you guys in the description below. So let's pretend, because hey, you know, it fits with their story. So let's pretend it's a drill. And they give these guys these bombs, and they're gonna catch them so they can bust this cell that they probably already knew about. Because if you didn't know, now these young men were linked to a 12-person sleeper cell here in the United States. And I'll leave that link below. So the kids, or these young men, attempt to do the bombing. And it goes bad. The bombs go off. Now the FBI is sitting there with their pants down. They just shit on themselves. And we're just imagining here, because I know there's a lot of other ideas out there about what happened and theories, okay? I'm just leaving them alone. I'm going with what they're telling us and building around that. If they want to tell us that these two did the bombings and it's them, okay. Now they're telling us that they're part of a cell. Okay, let's go through this. What if the FBI supplied them the bomb went bad, and they, now the FBI is left with, you know, this mess. Whether they identified the guys or not beforehand, they asked for our help to catch these guys, which gets these guys out in the open, because now they have to get out, now they have to run, because now their picture is everywhere, okay? So now they gotta run, they got whatever they were going to MIT for, I don't know what they were going over there for, but whatever they were going over there for, they went in there, and maybe if they're part of an operation that went bad, they probably had a couple other bombs sitting around, and they were like, oh yeah, you guys are going to screw us? Well, here you go. Okay, because the FBI would have then turned on them as soon as they put the pictures out. If that's the case. Just the scenario for you folks. So then they go there, and there's a big shootout, okay, and we heard anyways that the older brother got shot a few times, or, you know, and he died. Or at least that was what I heard early. Because the story has changed like 4,000 times, I swear. Now suddenly, the cops have the older boy. This is from the Weekly Standard. And Police Chief Edward DeVoe describes how the cops nearly apprehended the older brother. Nearly apprehended the older brother and were placing handcuffs on him in the middle of the street Thursday night. Official story from Mr. Police Chief Edward DeVoe. Link will be below. When the younger suspect came at officers in a hijacked SUV, the cops were able to dive out of the way, and the younger brother then continued to drive directly over his brother and dragging him through the streets. And that's how the older suspect died. So, the cops just doing their duty, you know, doing their duty, just throw the guy in front of the car while they dive out of the way to get hit by his brother. Early reports said he had a bomb strapped to his chest when this all occurred. I don't know. Any experts out there can tell me why the bomb might not have gone off if he got hit by a car and run over and dragged? Now, if you're the younger brother and that's your older brother and you love him so much that you're going to do a terrorist attack with him, one that you planned on surviving, by the way, it wasn't like they were suicide bombers, right? Would you really run over your brother? I mean, I'm just asking, I guess, just run him over? I don't know. Whatever. That's a question. So anyways, the younger brother takes off. There's a big shoot 'em out beforehand. So I don't know how many weapons these guys had on them, okay? So now they have this 19-year-old kid on the run. He's supposedly wounded from what we're told. And then they go on this massive manhunt for this guy. If it was an operation that has gone bad, wouldn't you want to catch this guy and make sure they couldn't talk? If you're the government. Locking it down, not allowing independent reporters to go out and film. That was the case for locking everything down so they could control the media. Then they also just decided to go in everybody's home without warrants. Hey, you know what? You don't have rights. You don't have rights. And there's no outrage that you don't have rights anymore. So they go through this whole thing. Chase him down, go to this boat after they violated how many thousands of people's rights to find one kid who's wounded, who's probably doesn't have much ammo left, because how much can you carry when you're on foot on the run? Okay, how much can you carry? A backpack full? Okay, but he just had to shoot him out. Would he stop at the Walmart and pick up some more bullets on the way? Just wondering. How many weapons can you actually have in that? Especially after a shootout. They find him in the boat and they come get him. Take him away to the hospital. This morning we find out he can't talk and they won't be able to find anything on him. Wouldn't that be convenient that he couldn't talk? If we go back to the scenario that these guys were supposed to get caught with the bombs in it and was a operation that went bad. But from what I'm reading, he's heavily sedated. Well, I would imagine so. If you're wounded, who knows how many times he was wounded. Anyways, I don't know if I made sense, okay, folks? But the whole thing here is, in all this, there's no outrage from the American people. And let me just throw this out at you. Since all the police and the military and the federal agents were tied up chasing this guy, lots of them, thousands of them were. Who's watching the harbor? And Make, if you're listening, this would go right into your Jericho scenario. While everybody's busy over here doing this, chasing this guy down. Now, wouldn't you want to chase the guy down if it was an operation gone bad, by the way? And forgive me for jumping around. Makes you think, doesn't it? But now there's a sleeper cell they're connected with. Are we going to have martial law all across the country until they get every one of the sleeper cells? Why is it that we're not hearing anybody, at least from, I mean, maybe I'm wrong, and if I am wrong, please leave me the links. Leave me some maybe Twitter accounts or something that I can see that people that were in that or anywhere in this country are outraged at the fact that the government pulled out all the stops to get one guy. That leaves the precedent for them, for this little cell here, if this is true, to just go all over the country and do it. I know tomorrow, I've already sent a letter to Carl Levin, but tomorrow I'm on the phone to my congressmen, my senators, my governor if I have to, and tell them this shit can't go on in our state. The government can violate all your rights to hunt somebody down. I mean, look at Christopher Dorner. They were shooting him up first, boom, not even knowing, not even people that even look like Christopher Dorner on their little manhunt there. People got wounded. Oops, right? Must be nice to be watching your freedom being flushed down the toilet. Must be nice. They closed airspace down. What, did they think the guy was going to fly a plane? His picture was all over. He couldn't get into an airport without being discovered. No way. You guys, let me know what you think. I know this was like super long. It's over 15 minutes long. I'll try to cut it down, edit it down. And I'll leave a bunch of other links below. I probably didn't hit everything. This is too much to talk about. So have a good day, folks. We'll talk to you. Bye.